fractions. Sometimes there's just no avoiding them. All right, I'm gonna show you two strategies for dealing with equations with fractions. First, no fear. Fraction's just a number, we treat it like any other number. So in this problem, we're gonna start off just like we usually do. We're gonna get all the variables on one side, constants on the other. So we're gonna start off by adding 3r over 5 to both sides. And this will get all our variable terms, all the terms of variables, onto one side of the equation. So on the left side here, we'll have 2r over 3 plus 3r over 5. I put my variable terms together, minus 7. And of course, these just cancel, so on the right side, we're left with 5. So I've succeeded. I got all the variable terms on the left side. Now I've got to combine these. I'm going to combine these just like we would if the fractions were any other number. We're going to factor out the r, so we have 2/3 plus 3/5 times the r minus 7 equals 5. We add these by finding a common denominator. Common denominator is 15, so we multiply top and bottom of 2/3 by 5, and we have 10/15. Multiply top and bottom of 3/5 by 3, plus 9/15, r minus 7 equals 5. We add those up, we get 19/15 times r minus 7 equals 5. And that's an equation we know how to handle. We have to isolate the r, so we're going to isolate this first. We add 7 to both sides. I'm going to put a line here, continue my work over there. When I add 7 to both sides, that'll cancel the 7 from the left and just leave 19 over 15 times r. And then on the right, 5 plus 7, of course, is 12. So now I need to eliminate the 19 over 15. We do that by multiplying by its reciprocal. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 15 over 19. Because, of course, 15 over 19 times 19 over 15, that's going to just be 1. So over here, we'll have r all by itself. And here we have 15 times 12 over 19. So let's see, how are we going to do that? 15 times 12, well, 15 times 10 is 150. 2 times 15 is 30. So 15 times 12 is 150 plus 30 is 180 over 19. And yeah, I'll let you stick that one back in and check it all by yourself. This is why you want to be particularly careful when you're working with fractions. Checking that answer is going to be a bit of a pain. But I'll show you another way to check it, and that is do the same problem but in a different way. This is strategy number 2 for dealing with fractions, that is, wipe them out, get rid of them. Now, how can we get rid of these fractions? Well, if we multiplied the left side by 3, that'll wipe out the 3 in the denominator here. We have to multiply the 7 by 3 as well. Got to be careful about that. But multiplying the right side by 3 won't help us with this fraction. Now, we have to multiply the right side by 3. If we multiply the left side by 3, can't play favorites. The right side, we have to wipe out the 5 by multiplying the right side by 5. Of course, you multiply the right side by 5, you have to multiply the left side by 5 too. So we want to multiply by 3, and we want to multiply by 5. That means we multiply by 15. So we're going to multiply both sides by 15. Now, our goal here, initially, is just get rid of the fractions. Once again, we can't play favorites. We have to multiply both sides of the equation by the same thing. And now we use the distributive property. We distribute this out. We have 15 times 2r over 3. We have to multiply the 7 by the 15 as well. 15 times 7. Now over here on the right, we get 15 times 5 minus 15 times 3r over 5. And sure enough, 15 times the 2r, that gives us 30r. 30r divided by the 3, that gives us 10r, and we have successfully wiped out that fraction. We also could have thought of this: 15 divided by 3 gives us 5, and 5 times 2r gives us 10r. And we have 7 times 15. Well, let's see, 7 times 10 is 70, 7 times 5 is 35. Add those together, and we get 105. 15 times 5, that's just 75. Now over here, 15 times 3r, that's 45r. 45r divided by 5 gives us 9r. Now once again, we could have gone 15 divided by 5 gives us 3. 3 times the 3r gives us 9r. Now this is a problem we know how to deal with. We add the 9r, add 9r to both sides to get all the variable terms on one side. We have 10r plus 9r gives us 19r minus 105 equals 75. Now if we add 105 to both sides, we get 19r equals 75 plus 105 equals 180, and then we divide both sides by 19, and we get r equals 180 over 19. That's the same answer as we had the first time. Same answer. We did the problem two different ways. We got the same answer, so we must be right. And we're done.